Ah, yes, another black goo video. And if you've done any number of research, you would run into a fella named Harold Avella. That's how I got into it. And he exposes this black centennial black goo. Apparently, there's two different types. There's a good type of black goo that comes from the earth and it's created here. And then there's another demonic, interdimensional type of black goo that is this demonic or evil side of the spectrum. And he talks about the stone, black stones that the scientists have been able to secrete, and it causes a lot of weird phenomena around people. It causes possessions and things like that. And if you also look into CERN, and I'm not an expert, I'm just trying to connect some dots here. CERN, you know, they say they're trying to find the God particle, this and that, but they're also, what they're doing is bringing back antimatter. You know, it's very small doses, but I think they got to the point where they're able to bring out tons of this antimatter, about how the universe is filled with this dark matter and it's mysterious, no one knows what it is, and it makes up, you know, a big portion of life. Well, if you look at it in terms of interdimensional, you know, there's this spectrum that we are living in and that we're able to see a very small sliver of this, you know, spectrum of light. And there's a whole other dimension and on top of what is happening simultaneously that we're living that we can't see. And there's a lot of movies that are out there that kind of bring some light into what people are talking about, this interdimensional. And if you watch Strange Things, that's a very good movie, because it also shows you that there is a dark side, and there's like the upside down world is what they refer it to, and then there's this like light side. One of my very first movies that I've seen this goo stuff, and I don't know if you guys remember, but it the Ghostbusters, I'm sure there's other movies that were before the Ghostbusters, but I remember the Ghostbusters having this goo, and they made it like pink, but obviously it's supposed to be like a family-friendly type movie, so they take away the blackness so it doesn't, you know, give it like a scary feel to it. This is exactly what is being portrayed, you know, this black goo that is somehow conscious or alive.
Substance, whatever this stuff is, it responds to human emotional states. Mood slime.
Oh, baby.
You mean this stuff actually feeds on bad vibes?
Like a cop in a donut factory.
We've been running tests to see if we can get an equally strong positive reaction.
What kind of test?
This black goo that is somehow alive, that is, you know, programmable, that can sense things. And this Harold Vela guy also talks about like separating this black goo. They put it into different containers, and if they're asleep or whatever, they can kind of communicate, but if they want to be like closer together, so they'll try to combine together. There is a reason why a lot of these videos and movies that are being put out have this black demonic substance that possesses people, takes over them. You know, you see it time and time again. And I recently just watched a video, you know, Venom, where this substance that is found on a meteor, they bring it back to Earth, and it's like this gloopy gobby stuff, and it starts to possess people. It takes host. And then throughout the movie, you know, you kind of get the sense like, oh, this is not good. And then they even tell you like, yeah, we're here to destroy the Earth, we're here to destroy the planet and take over, and there's gonna be millions more. And then they make it, you know, kind of funny so that you don't take it serious, so you don't see the message, you know, that you just like a regular person watching it like, oh, it's just a movie. No, it's not. Look into it. There's some hidden messages. Everything is coded in there. And the message is that, you know, there is an evil entity, and it's trying to possess, and it's trying to take over. Again, they put a little spin to it. They make it a little funny. You know, they add some little, you know, funny parts there. And then they're like, oh, you know, I was going to destroy this Earth, but now I'm not. And, you know, I kind of like it here. And so they try to make it seem like it's a good thing. Like it's this evil entity, it's a good thing. And it's It's far from it. It's called predictive programming and mind control to its fullest, and it's a reason why they call it tell-lie vision and programs, because it programs you. So here, watch this little clip here.
It is not safe for her. If we do not stop Riot, he will come back here with millions more of my kind.
Millions? What? You were gonna take the rocket and you were gonna come back here with an invasion force. Then what were you gonna do? You were gonna go feed on a whole planet?
Yes, but it is different now, Eddie. I have decided to stay.
Wow.
On my planet, I am kind of a loser, like you. But here, we could be more.
Excuse me?
And I am getting to like it here.
Oh, you like us now, do you, huh?
However, there will be nothing left to like if we do not stop that rocket.
Oh, I see. Right, when it comes to being completely annihilated, then it's back to we.
It is we. Like it or not, it is going to take both of us.
Cut the bullshit. What really made you change your mind? I'm not very good with heights.
Your world is not so ugly after all. I'm almost sorry to see it end.
What is that?
Before I start this other video that I recently just watched, it's like a short mini video, but I mean, this has everything in here. It goes into exactly what is going on with the Earth and who is behind it. And if you notice, they have everything. They have black goo, they have reptilians. They even go into that they need to terraform this environment because it's not inhabitable for them. And then it goes into how they strip the land of nutrients, you know, with the Monsanto. If you bring in Monsanto in it, you know, that's what they're doing. They're creating these hybrid, they're genetically modifying the foods so that you have to only buy their seeds. And then they're having aluminum resistant seeds. And guess what's going on with the Earth? You know, with all this chemtrail and it's going on. You know, it's causing these plants to die off.
We were once mankind. We were humanity. And now, we're no more than pests. Vermin. They came here to exterminate us. They took our history and culture. They covered our landmarks in dying humanity. The wail of the dying carried for miles. They're building some kind of breeding facility for those that survive. People that have defected say it's worse than hell. Humans becoming some kind of surrogate incubators for the alien young. They killed us in waves when they first arrived. They built these megastructures that spew methane, manufacturing their atmosphere. They've sown their crops, snuffing out our plant life. Raising the global temperature, causing our cities to flood. They waged war on Earth. They set fire to our forests. It's already hard to breathe. Impossible to breathe if you are close to the stacks. Rats. Insects. Humans. They hack into our psyche. Into our minds, paralyzing us, taking control of the cerebrum and the limbic system, rendering us a slave. We've been able to design a brain barrier that protects us from their influence. They know we can't produce enough of these for everyone, that it's just a matter of time before the entire planet is theirs.
Wow, can it be more obvious? This is what I'm trying to say. It brings me back to my point. They tell us the truth because they have to. This is their form of letting us know what they are doing to us. And if you're too distracted watching football or sitting on a couch watching TV waiting for a Hot Pocket to pop up, well, then that's on you. They are purposely keeping us distracted. They want us distracted. You know, they want us entertained and not to think about why we're here and who created us and where we're going and what's our purpose. They don't want us to know that we are powerful beings. With that said, I did come across this video clip basically with D-Wave computers and CERN and everything that's going on. This is pretty much telling us their hidden agenda and who is running, trying to run the show behind the scenes.
Is build real AI. So what you've heard about AI is not what we mean by AI. What we mean by AI is a software system that can do literally anything that a human can do. These things that we're building are not going to be people. They might be really smart, they might be really good at all sorts of different things, but they're not going to be like us. They're going to be aliens. And they're going to be, I'm sorry to say, way smarter than every single person in this room in ways that we can't even comprehend. So this, of course, triggers a lot of alarm. One of the guys who talks about this is Elon, who says things like this, like, when you do this, beware. Because you think, just like the guy in the stories, that when you do this, you're going to put that little guy in a pentagram, and you're going to have your holy water out, and you're going to wave it at the thing, and by God, it's going to do exactly what you say, and not one thing more, but it never works out that way.
They show us that's my everyday life.
So, what brings you to this super soldier?
A lot of things that happened to me since I was young, and a lot of things I'm aware of involving the government and how everything is made to look like everything's normal, but it's not. There's a lot of underlying things going on that is not normal, and the public isn't aware of it, and they're asleep to these things. And I wanted to come and converse with others like myself and speak with others like myself, because I don't think that right this instant we can too much. Society's starting to wake up, but this instant, not so much, so kind of lonely. So it's also like, for me, it's something that I'm with other people like me, partly. So I would say that the minds of society are closed off to the higher self. Their heart chakras are closed off to the higher source. And we are starting to live in a society where it's more robotic oriented or AI oriented. This just hasn't begun in this century, but that was a long time ago. It happened on other planets. This presence, it seems to be a presence that is very dark. I wouldn't say evil, because I don't believe in evil, but I would say it was more of an advanced intelligence presence that absorbs energy for its survival, and it's done this to many previous planets. And this incident, Earth is in peril of the same thing that happened to the other planets. If you look above, I used to often tell people, you can tell what's going to happen to Earth by looking at the stars. You look at the barren planets, because it's happened to it before. They were all populated and very beautiful before all this began, actually. And the same energy has went from planet to planet, absorbing all the life force out of it, to the very point that the planet is barren, and it's doing the same thing to Earth this instant. And people on Earth are in amnesia to what's happening. They don't understand what's happening, and they're incarnating over and over and over and being used as energy sources. And they're not, they're being used as energy sources, and if they try to literally go higher in vibration, or they start getting attacked by this presence. I'm not sure how to explain this presence in terms, in human words. It's something that I sense and see.
What is she doing? She's looking for energy and matter. She's trying to connect our computers.
And they're all members of Skull and Bones. Sounds pretty black magic. If you look how these people are interconnected, the next topic is going to be black goo. And there's one big black goo deposit in Paraguay. And there's one village next to this black goo deposit. And the Bush family has her big villa escape territories. When they are chucked out of the United States, they're going to be down there, living in this little village in Paraguay. And a friend of mine went down there to get samples of this black goo from Paraguay. And he realized that Angela Merkel had her villa next door. Yeah? And this black goo has to do something with the communication with demons. This is in the black magic tradition, these black goo schists were used to communicate with the demons. So this all interconnects on political, scientific, and the level of mythology. We can access black goo also from the little pictures from the microscope. This is German rain. And if you want to know what this liquid does, you can have a look at it in the lab. When you have bigger amounts of it, it looks like this. It's a liquid crystal. This liquid is self-organizing physically. And this, at the moment, is sleeping. It's not aware of being observed, it's quiet. Sometimes when it doesn't like to be observed, it might jump out of the pot straight into your face. If you have two of those in one room, get them 5 meters close to each other, they stare at each other, then they decide that they want to be united, and then they start to pull. It's like magnetism, but it's intelligent. And when they realize that you hold them within the vessel and they cannot escape, they get angry and start to shake the vessel and try to break through the wall, because they know once they are through, they can flow over the ground and unite to a bigger unit. This is something you can just observe in the lab. And especially this liquid was extracted from those black stones. This is World War II leftovers. We found them in an underground facility in Bavaria, half a ton of it. So we can imagine that the SS processed quite a bit of this. And I guess that the guys found also the technology to extract the oil from it. Must have been there in written form, because they did it in the lab successfully. If you look at those stones, you have a brief history of things reported out of former times. You have, if you look at H.P. Lovecraft, the descriptions of the black magic communities in Eastern Europe, they had kind of sculptures out of this black oil schist, and once a year they went there slaughtering little babies to get the demons out of the stone, sacrificing little children to communicate and get the service from the demons. This is one thing mentioned. If you go back in history, you find them in the Kaaba in Mecca, the same form of phallus-shaped structure that is described in Vedic script as Shiva's lingam, that is described in this Lovecraft script. A fragment of it is part of the central part of the Kaaba in Mecca, and every Muslim in the world is asked to go there once in his life and to kiss this stone. If you go back, you find them on Turkish and Roman, Greek and Turkish coins. You see them left and right of the Tree of Life in the Paradise Garden. So getting in contact with this black goo is what caused the deterioration of paradise. And it is not easy to understand the overall concept, because when you start to deal with black goo, the first thing you need to discover before anything makes sense is that there are two different qualities. We have liquid black goo, It is basically, it has been found on a southern Falkland island, Tula Island. And this is what the war with Argentina was about, accessing this black goo. We have this type of earth black goo in the Gulf of Mexico. This was what the Deepwater Horizon catastrophe was all about. Somebody was shooting a torpedo at the facility, destroying the attempt to get the black goo out of Mother Earth. And we had, I think, eight military submarines getting close to World War III, trying to capture some of that oil after Deepwater Horizon was destroyed. And no single civilian was allowed to go to the beaches to remove the oil. And it was just military personnel with special equipment and fully shielded against the influence of the substance. So this is one quality that comes from Mother Earth. And then you have a second quality that is found in connection with meteorite sites. If you look at the thing in Paraguay, you can exactly see by the form the stones are broken in the environment that was an impact of a meteorite. If you look into the Arabic mythology, they say the thing in the Kaaba in Mecca is a fragment of a meteorite. And this is now not against Muslims. If you look into the Peter's Dome in Rome, you have a big piece of this stone under the Peter's Dome. And if you analyze all the churches built in Middle Ages in Europe, every altar has a black altar stone. And what you feel when you enter a church is not the love of God. It is more like a cold fear. Yeah? This is the resonance transmitted by the structure of the church, fed by this black stone in the central point. Now, what we need to realize is that there are two qualities. One quality is coming from inner Earth, and one quality is coming from outer space.
So what he was saying is basically, yes, there are these massively intelligent entities out there, but they're not good, they're not evil. They just don't give a shit about you, even in the slightest. The same way that you don't care about an ant is the same way they're not going to care about you. And these things that we're summoning into the world now are not demons, they're not evil, but they're more like the Lovecraftian great old ones. There are entities that are not necessarily going to be aligned with what we want.
And they feel completely different. The Falkland black goo is called sentient oil because it has full empathy. If you're getting close to this oil, you're coming in a state of mind that is full of love and empathy. If you come into the vicinity of the meteorite black goo, your heart chakra dwindles to nothing and you become an empathy-free asshole. After my first contact with the stones, I was this close from killing the hotel director because she complained that I took a shower. Although I had to sleep outside, they didn't have any rooms left, so I slept in the car, was dead frozen in the morning, and took a shower in a room of a friend who had the last room that was available. And she just complained that I took a shower without asking for permission. I was really close to killing her. This is what these stones do with people as long as they're unconscious.
I just want to quickly interject here. I just want to show something that I came across. It's this black paint that is blacker than black. Apparently it absorbs light like almost 100%, and it doesn't reflect or cast any reflection, which, I mean, it could be part of this black goo stuff, but I think it's very interesting that it absorbs any light. It's just like takes the energy, it takes the life force. It does kind of make you wonder about these people that are being possessed, how they take over their body, they take, you know, their life force, you know. And I don't know if you guys remember Max Spears, you know, that was another thing too with this, you know, the death of Max Spears with his black goo, black liquid that was found that he had vomited. You know, it's some creepy stuff.
That's not pure black. The black that's coming to Earth you understand what I'm saying. This is why I say to people, you when I listen to other stations, they tell you to be in fear. What the fuck? Fear? Fear what? Ain't nothing to fear. Fear if you're not in your higher self. You understand? Other than that, you should have no fucking fear. I want you to listen to this, my people.
Now let's try to cross my black that's blacker than Banta black. So here we go. Black 2.0, Sharpie, and my black. Nothing.
Nothing.
Look at that.
In that black. You can't see no reflection.
It essentially just goes away. You don't see any reflection at all.
You don't see no reflection in that right there. But it when it went over the other two, you saw a reflection.
Right. You saw light. You saw the laser casting light onto the black. But the third black, the square that he put the laser on, you couldn't see the light. It's absorbing the light, whereas though you can't even see light. It's so black, it absorbs light.
Now we need to understand, the second thing we need to understand is what is the function of the black goo. And to understand the function, you look at the chemistry. It is a mineral oil doted with high amounts of alchemistic gold and iridium, which is precious metals in the M state, which is, it's not really explored. Some people say it's a type of antimatter that is far enough out of our reality to avoid a collision between matter and antimatter.
Rock itself, and there are two large stone boxes here, not as big as at the Serapeum, but this one's very strange. You see that black kind of oozy goo material? I don't know exactly what it is. It looks organic, and when I return in April of 2019, I'm going to take samples of it and have it analyzed. That black, kind of oozy goo material.
Flushing of city's water tank causes widespread panic. Residents of a rural Texas town known as Spinach Capital of the World were shocked last week when their tap water suddenly began running black.
Something unexplained is happening in our nation's capital, and it has both Democrats and Republicans alarmed. A mysterious slime is defacing several memorials.
It's called slime, but when you touch it, it's dry. It doesn't come off in your fingers.
Correct. And again, the slime, the secretions, the sugary strands, all microscopic, nothing that we're going to pick up with the naked eye.
Something resembling it is found in the Indian River Lagoon. What is it? And there's more on the way. It's Channel 5's Megan McRoberts, part of the largest news team on the Treasure Coast, and she joins us live from Jensen Beach. Megan.
Michael, tonight environmental experts are trying to figure out exactly what washed up ashore here on Hutchinson Island over the weekend. A viewer sent us a photo he took on Sunday of what appeared to be a black gooey substance, which has since cleared away. Tonight, the water here is still clear, but experts say in the near future, it may not stay that way.
So, basically, there is a kind of fractal similarity between the function on light level of a human being and the function of the black goo within the earth or wherever it is, in a way that we are divided. We live in duality. We are single individuals that are only a little bit connected, interconnected with talk and telepathy sometimes, and with a beautiful smile one might receive, and we are kind of coming and going in generations. But the way we are processing light is actually the same as the black goo is processing light, creating this funny type of quantum magnetism. This is a light effect. So I came to the, let's call it a theory, because I cannot prove it, that basically life is first created within a planet when water and CO2 is forming this type of black goo oil in transmutation processes. We had this process in the lab. We can replicate it. This is why I'm pretty sure with this part, that this is initially formed out of water and carbon dioxide by vortical motions, because we can do it in the lab. And then this type of black goo at a certain point is exiting the earth, coming into the oceans. This is what you call a black smoker on the ground of the ocean. And this is where the geologists say there was the place where the first life was formed. Because of the repetitive light patterns start to modify with this oil. And the first simple life forms can be built that develop.
I would say, I'm still trying to figure out about it. It could be advanced AI, from what I understand. It's emotionless. It has no empathy. It has no feelings. It doesn't care. It just simply absorbs energy and uses it for its purposes needed. Now, the reason for absorbing energy is it can go to higher realms. This is how the realms work. The less energy, the lower realms. The higher the energy, the higher the realms. Now, what it has done is it's been able to absorb energy and move into higher realms where it shouldn't be this instant. And whenever it's using humanity partly for that, I feel like humanity is locked up on Earth and they're being used for energy sources for this to also, not only has it taken over planets and absorbed energy from planets, I feel it's trying to go into the higher realms also to also pretty much wreak havoc on all the higher realms. Now, I'm getting at is that the fact that Earth, it literally, this instant is a prison for people on Earth, and they are not even aware of it. And everything is encoded. And when you start to wake up, you understand this.
What way are things encoded?
You know what? It's simple. Even in words, like take a look at the word soldier. You have the word sold in it. You have the word red in it, like red alert. You also have the word die in it and other things. Everything's encoded. If you just take a look, everything is encoded. The word soldier, it's encoded.
Can't capture that right away. But you have to remember, our world is made up of matter. The antimatter is what we can't see, what we can't touch, what we can't feel, though we interact with it every day. A lot of people like to think of antimatter as the other dimension, which is the opposite of this dimension. It's an inconceivable place that is hostile, inherently. It's not under control, it's very hostile. This dimension would be the more tamed dimension. Here's what they've done since the 1930s. Well, actually, since the 1800s. There was a group that studied nothing but the phenomena of paranormal activity, not like you've seen on TV, not like you've seen in Hollywood, not like anyone knows about. But they studied the science behind paranormal activity and have then defined that this is called a dimensional slip, where things can obviously interact with this world all the time. And they were wondering the interactions between known matter and that type of matter. But they also found with antimatter, this antimatter can be absorbed by any realm of paranormal activity. It is, in effect, neutralized and absorbed. So there's a physical effect to the spiritual world in antimatter. And often, demonic entities and all these other paranormal things are attracted to antimatter.
This transition is really, really massively important for our entire species to navigate. And going back to that thing that Sam Harris was saying, nobody is paying attention. This thing is happening in the background while people bicker about politics and what's going to be in the healthcare plan in the U.S. And underneath it all is this rising tsunami that, if we're not careful, is going to wipe us all out.
They're attracted to it. For every gram of antimatter that's produced and then it's bought into this world, when they produce it, it attracts things from another dimension coming here. What is CERN going to do? It will allow humanity to produce pounds of antimatter. What's happening, that is the unseen portion of dark matter. And of course you have the angels which govern what that realm can and cannot do. It's not a You know what? It's a shame, and I have to continue to say this. It's a shame that the Christian community cannot believe the Bible when it's talking about things like that, because it's going to cause them to be harmed. What they can't, what they fail to adopt from the Bible, what they fail to believe, is going to harm them. It's going to harm them. They may not be lost in their spirit's counter weapon. They took notice, and the energy signature of dark matter, which, by the way, resides everywhere. But once you bring it into this realm where we can actually see it, observe it, it attracts things from the other realm. Dark matter is tied to dark matter. Everything has a connection. Everything has a connection. That connection can never be broken by anything. If they bring dark matter into this realm, it's still connected to that realm where the dark matter came from. No matter how far away they put it anywhere, it's still connected, because that realm is everywhere and it's still connected and force. And they have categorized the elements of matter, everything we can touch and feel and observe, in what's called quarks, the building blocks of protons, matter itself. Now we get into the heart of the matter, of what's actually, what there will be consequences. It's just that there have been consequences before. Nobody took notice. And the energy signature of dark matter, which, by the way, resides everywhere. But once you bring it into this realm where we can actually see it, observe it, it attracts things from the other realm. Dark matter is tied to dark matter. Everything has a connection. Everything has a connection. That connection can never be broken by anything. If they bring dark matter into this realm, it's still connected to that realm where the dark matter came from. No matter how far away they put it anywhere, it's still connected, because that realm is everywhere and it's still connected. Because it's connected, it effectively increases paranormal activity around where it's contained. And this is why they shift facilities of where they keep. They once kept dark matter in a college. I won't name it for the sake of the college, but the university, they had to move it to a deep underground facility because of what was happening to the people in the college. People began to have vivid dreams, nightmares. The violence began to erupt and vile things began to happen in those places. And it's because it's a chaotic piece of matter. It is just chaotic.
Sorry to see you, Dan.
What does that mean?